Hi friends, today we'll be looking at the poem of Kelly Clarkson. She is one of the most famous female singers in the world. She is most known for winning the first season of American Idol in 2002 at just the age of 20. So we will be looking at her poem, her astrological chart and her numerical chart. So first of all, we see that this woman's poem is very powerful and very loving. But the thing is that there are two sides to each personality. First of all, the reason for her early success is that the line of head and life are not joined at the start. So this gives an independent personality. Then we see the thumb. Now the thumb is extremely long. The problem with this kind of thumb is that it's high set, so there's a lot of stubbornness and in regards to one's career especially. And then we see that even though the will phalange and logic phalange are almost equal, which is good, it's good for balance, we still see that the thumb, the shape of the thumb is very, what do you say, fully formed. So she can be very stubborn about things. But the good thing is that the way her hand is, the good heart line, the good Venus mount, the good moon mount, these things negate that. Like, she is stubborn, but she will be for the right causes. And she has stood up to very many big people in the industry, like the Sony BMG record producer Clive Davis, who, when she released her third album in 2007, My December, it was rumored that he wanted to either delete the full album or replace 5 songs with more radio-friendly singles. But she refused. She even cancelled her tours. So basically, she is a very non-materialistic type of person. I don't see materialism in her hand, which is very surprising for such a person who's gained so much success at such a young age. And that is her primary force. This woman is very philanthropic. She can be sometimes unreasonably stubborn. And also, her weight has been fluctuating. She did say she has an autoimmune disease, which can also be seen by the weak lifeline. If we see the lifeline, it is not strong. It is like only till here. It's not like, it's only till, I would say, going on till around the age of 30 or something, or like 28 to 30. So this is around the time when she also maybe took a more stand for herself. Like, before that she was, you know, being managed by people and stuff. Then she, you know, after first album left Idol management and then, you know, went her own way. She, like, many people were not expecting her to go into pop rock with her second album, but she did it. So it's like she took control of her life. It's not like the lifeline totally ends. It is still going, but it is lighter because she has less burden on herself. Of course, her lifeline was darker then because she also had, you know, the competition within the American Idol. But what is the reason for her success are 3 mounts. The Venus mount, which gives her passion, the moon mount, which gives her creativity, and the Apollo mount, which gives her the artistic talent needed to succeed. We see again she is very disciplined when it comes to her career, not taking drugs and such, because the first and third finger are almost as long as the Saturn finger. The Saturn finger is not that long and the Saturn mount is not that developed, which shows a rebellious attitude, especially in youth. So it is hard to tame this woman. And again, I would still say that overindulgence is also shown. We also see that when the moon mount and Venus mount are developed, the person gets a sudden rise in life. This could be late in life, this could be early in life. Leonardo DiCaprio and The Rock, the Dwayne Johnson also have this. But what is very harmful about the Venus and moon mount development is the overindulgence. This could be eating, smoking, anything. So many people with this condition, they tend to either stay very overweight or stay very underweight. So there's a very less chance of middle ground. But I think recently she has become fit. And again, it could be due to her autoimmune disorder as well, even though I don't know the specific details. We also see that her you know, fate line is tied to the lifeline. So this means she is, like, you know, she hasn't forgotten her roots. She is a very devout Christian. She might be very close to her family. And you know, her, because it comes from the Venus side, okay? So the Venus side is all the passion, the love, the success in the person's own country. So you see that even though, of course, she is successful worldwide, she got her most fame from American Idol. She would have not been maybe so this much famous without American Idol, because she, you know, she became the flagship star of that show. She became the first one and became the flagship star. So I see good things ahead. I would only I also see her concentrating more on family matters, because the fate line is not that strong in the mid-30s. So she's 38 now, she has 2 children. She did divorce her husband recently, but I still see her being more family-oriented, less career oriented. She is doing, I think, a talk show nowadays, but she will concentrate more on raising her family, which is good. This is the age to do it because she's already established. Then, you know, working on her career, so you can maybe expect less songs from her, and I would also expect her children to be very successful in career, in education, and for them to have a lifelong good relationship, because she is very loving and caring about those who matter to her. She also has strong third phalanges, which gives energy, and the other phalanges which are developed are the first phalanges, which gives the person like intellectualism. She not intellectualism in the sense of, you know, being good in studies, I don't know about her studies and stuff, but intellectual in the sense that being a good writer, being a good songwriter, because she took her own direction and she believes that her vision is the best, which it is, because she's a feeling person. She doesn't do anything without feeling. We also see that the little finger, the most strong phalange, is the first and third. So again, she is vocal, which is shown by the first phalange, and she is, you know, headstrong and believes in herself because of the third phalange, very energetic. But again, the third phalange and the you know, stuffiness, the, you know, pump hand, even though it's square shaped, it does show overindulgence in food and drinking. So she really needs to take care of it, especially if she becomes pregnant again. This type of hand also shows that the person will have a lot of children and be very successful in raising them and be a very good parent, have lifelong good relationships with the children because of the Moon and Venus months development, especially the Venus months. So these people tend to have at least minimum 2 kids. They can even have like many kids, depends on their own choice, but she does have minimum 2 kids. But I would be surprised again if she, because I don't know if she's in a relationship now, but the heart line is romantic, it is going upwards, so this means that she will eventually find true love again and enter a very long lasting relationship and most probably have 1 or 2 more kids. So now we go to the other aspects. So now we see she is Taurus. So Taurus people, it's very actually representative, because if you see her, she's you know, very curvaceous and naturally curvaceous, and her face is the forehead is very large, like the Taurus people have large foreheads. So physically she also inhabits those things. Taurus is ruled by Venus. Her most dominant mount in the hand near the thumb is Venus. So we see that as well. And Taurus is the most non-materialistic and artistic sign among the 3 earth signs, which are Capricorn, Virgo and Taurus. So this is also reflected. Furthering the Venus aspect is number 6. Now, number 6, people born on the, you know, 6th, 15th or 24th of any date are number 6 people. So these people are also non-materialistic. They tend to be very good looking. They tend to be very charming. They tend to, you know, attract good things in their life because of their Venusian energies. They tend to excel in artistic activities. They tend to excel in anything that they wholeheartedly believe in. They are naturally rich people, but they will not be misers. They will be spending on other people. They will also be spending a lot on themselves. Like they like the luxurious life. Good living matters to them more than saving money. So many times they could even end up losing money because they're so non-materialistic. If they do get an advantage over people, they won't use it. So many leaders or people who are in upper management, actually they do excel in leadership and upper management, which is ironic because of their good-heartedness. So they always leave behind a good legacy. They have the least chance of being corrupted unless they live in a very corrupt environment and have other unfavorable aspects. So again, this increases everything on the palm, and it correlates with that as well, because her Venus is the most strongest, her Taurus is her sun sign, which is also ruled by Venus, and number 6 is also ruled by Venus. So this woman is very loving, caring, but again, the non-materialism can hurt her as well, because if she had maybe gone, you know, of course she took her own way, she found success, but suppose she had gone the materialistic way, maybe she would have been richer now, because you know, Clive Davis is a big producer. So I'm just saying that she is not interested in money, and that is very good, because you know, some people change, but she has, and she will remain the same. She will be righteous and true and talented. She already is, and it's no surprise that she has gotten success from the age of 20 itself, and that she won the first American Idol. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a nice day ahead. Thank you. Goodbye.